The after-school grant is the same as the 21st CCLC grant. It allows organizations to create multiple grants. Therefore, when viewing the instructions for the 21st CCLC grant in the Part 2 video, these instructions apply to the after-school grant as well. Welcome to Part 2 of the EGMS training for the after-school grant, 21st Century Community Learning Centers grant, and the Primary Mental Health grant. In this video, we will discuss how to resolve validation messages, how the approval workflow goes with competitive grants, printing, and also we'll show you how to create multiple applications in the 21st Century Community Learning Centers grant. For this section of the video, we will assume that you're ready to submit one of your applications. We'll go to Funding Applications, and we're going to choose the after-school grant. And it looks like you're in application started status, and we're ready to go to application completed, which means that you're submitting the application for review. Click on Application Completed and you'll notice that you get a message that status cannot be changed, one or more validation errors exist. Click here to view the errors. I'm going to return just briefly to show you that I could have also seen that I had error messages by looking at the validation column, and I see a several messages link. Now, a message link will show up. This one particular one is for the whole entire application. The link also shows up for sections and for individual pages. It's advisable to hit this top link because that will show you all of the error messages in the application. There are two types of validation messages. One is an error message. One is a warning message. An error message must be resolved before you can submit the applications. The warning messages will not prevent you from submitting an application. However, they can affect your application if you have not uploaded certain information. As you can see, most of these messages deal with related documents that are not there, and they're all optional related documents. But for, in this case where we have a lot of the CBO documents, if you happen to be a CBO submitting them, those would be documents that should have been submitted. So it's a good idea to look at these warnings just to make sure you haven't left something out that should have been submitted. Now then, to correct an error, you'll notice that there's a review link in front of a message that will take you directly to the page that's having the problem. And so on this page, we read that the message said that there were some required fields. And as we look down through here, we see that there was a field here that was left out. Okay, while we're here, on this particular grid, this is an organizational chart, and we notice that it must indicate role. You know, we have three roles that must be filled in, but you may have additional people, and on a lot of grids, you'll see this add row functionality that allows you to add additional rows, which once you've added a row like that, notice that all of the fields are required, so you may need to use the delete button if you've added one incorrectly. Let's go back to the sections page and our messages link, and you'll see that now that we've filled in that incomplete information, that error message is now gone. Let's look at this second one. We also have one that questions marked with an asterisk require a response. Click on review, and we'll notice that this is one of your assurances page. These are easy to overlook. They generally on these assurances pages will have a checkbox that needs to be selected indicating your agreement with those assurances. If we go back to our sections now, we see that we only have the warning messages. We'll click on here and it takes us to the related documents section, which contains all of the documents that have potential for uploading. You'll notice that the top has required documents. These must be uploaded. And then of course the messages that we're getting are that these optional documents have not been uploaded. And again, it's a good idea to check these warning messages to see if that's something that needs to be included with your application. Now that we've taken care of the error messages themselves, we'll click on Application Completed. And you'll notice that we have a checkbox here that indicates an agreement. Click on Confirm. And you'll now see that it goes to LEA Superintendent Approved. And again, LEA Superintendent also means for non-state agency or non-district people. That's also your organizational authority. Notice that the LEA Superintendent has two options. They can approve it or they can return it. Many times people submit an application and then realize that they forgot to add something or they needed to correct something. They can locally they can make that correction by having a person with this role to return the application. And again, if you need to see who has those roles, go over here to the address book. And you'll see that there's three people here that have that LEA superintendent role, so that any of those three people can return this application. So let's just say that he's just going to approve the application. One thing to notice that once an application is completed and in the approval process, all fields will be locked down. The only field that can be used in the application is the Create Comment field, which can be used at any time. An application must be either in Application Started or in a Returned status before any edits can be made. For organizational authorities or superintendents, the process is that you will log in the same manner that any other user would log in. You go to Funding Applications and to the grant. You will have received an email anytime an application changes status. An email to the next person in the approval process will be sent. So Brian has received an email saying the after-school grant has moved to application completed status. He'll log in, click on approved, and notice that he also has a confirmation and a statement that he has to agree to, and click on confirmed. Once the application has been approved by the local authority, either the organizational authority or the LEA superintendent, it goes to the state, at which time they may return it to the LEA for edits. Perhaps something has been left off and the LEA has called and said that they need to attach it. For some other reason, it's a rare occurrence, but the state does have the opportunity to return it for edits. If it is returned, it is opened for editing. Then they can also review and approve for funding or review not approved for funding. Once an application reaches the state reviewer will use the new applicant summary screen, and they can either not approve it for funding or approve for funding. Once it's been approved for funding, there's the opportunity for the state to send it back again for minor corrections, or they can approve the application as it is. Once the application is approved, if you go to the allocations page, you will notice that the allocation has now been changed to the amount that was submitted in the budget. While the applications in the EGMS system are designed to be completed and worked online, there may be occasions when you want to print out the application. Anyone with access to the grant can do a print, and the print can be done regardless of the status of the application. Printing is done from the sections page. In the far right column, you will notice print beside each row. The print at the top will print out the entire application, including the history log and all pages that you can have access to from this page. You can print out the entire application. You can print out just a section that contains these pages, or you can print an individual page. If you want to do it cafeteria style, in other words, just print selected pages, click on the checkbox and then select the pages that you want to print out. Then you select the print link. Printing is done by converting the pages into a PDF document, which then you will print out. The next print request page asks you for an email address and the document name. The reason is that if a print job takes longer than 30 seconds to convert to a PDF file, an email will be sent to you. And you can open the email and open the CSDE resources and find the document and print from there. If it only takes less than 30 seconds to create the PDF, you won't be receiving an email, and the application will open in a PDF document directly. We're going to click on print, and we can see that this particular print job did not take longer than 30 seconds and popped up immediately in our window as a PDF, where we can click on the print icon, or we can download we can download the PDF to our computer. If the print job takes longer than the 30 seconds, you will receive this message. You will receive an email when it is complete, but occasionally those emails may go into the junk folder or may be overlooked. You can always go to the CSDE resources and any print job that has been completed will be at the top of the CSDE resources and will remain there for 5 days. Click on the link and you can open the application and again print from here or download it to your computer. Those organizations that apply for the 21st CCLC grant know that you can submit multiple applications for different programs. The way this is handled in EGMS can be seen on the sections page. Notice in the CCLC section that we have a drop-down which defaults to district level. Clicking on the drop-down, you'll see that you have Add Grant, a Delete Grant Application, and Rename Grant Application. You will add a grant application for every different program or application that you would normally have submitted. Click on Add Grant Application. Enter the application name. Now in the drop-down, you'll see that you have the grant that you just added. And when you select that grant, a series of pages representing the grant application pages for this particular application appear. I'm going to put just one, fill in one field here so that we can see the difference. Notice that if I select the grant application ABC Centers, I see the data that I put in there. If I create a second grant, once I've added a second grant, it will also appear here. And clicking on this second grant application, I have the same series of pages. However, you'll notice that it's a completely different application that different data can be entered into. You can easily switch between the applications from the sections page, or you can also use the Save and Go To button. Noticing that when you are on this CCLC section, you have access to both grants from the drop-down menus. Each grant will have its own budget. Noticing I have $75,000 in one budget here, and I have $50,000 in another budget. One other way to make sure that you're in the correct application is to notice your information bar at the top. Not only do you have your district or your organization, what fiscal year and your grant, you will also show which of the applications this particular page is designated for. Going back to the sections page, you'll notice that when you click on the district level, you have a district level budget and budget overview. Your district level budget is a roll-up of both grants. So we had one grant with $75,000 and another grant of $50,000 for a total of $125,000 being submitted by this particular organization. This concludes part two of the training videos for eGMS. We strongly encourage you to go to CSDE Resources, click on eGMS Training, and download the eGMS User Guide. This guide is in a Microsoft Word format and is easy to use to access information, additional information and reference material concerning eGMS. Also, use the Request Help button to submit help desk tickets and to call the help desk. If you need assistance with the grant content itself and have questions about the grant itself, look at Program Help and find the CSDE contact for the after-school CCLC and primary mental health grants. Thank you for viewing this video.